Today, we're announcing FX Factory 9, an exciting release that brings our best visual effects plugins to DaVinci Resolve. It takes just one step. Download and install FX Factory 9 from our website. Our app will automatically download any products newly updated to support Resolve. You can filter our catalog to show products for Resolve, or check each product individually. Our plugins can be used both with the free version of Resolve, as well as Resolve Studio. Make sure you have version 20 installed, and that it was downloaded from Blackmagic Design's website. Third-party plugins like FxFactory cannot be used with the version of DaVinci Resolve distributed through the App Store. Once in Resolve, FxFactory plugins can be used from the edit page. We'll cover plugins running in the Fusion and Color pages in a future tutorial. Open the Effects panel, where you'll find our filters, generators, and transitions under the FxFactory category. Plugins are organized by product. Applying an effect is as easy as dragging it over your timeline. I'll apply the FxFactory Pro halftone filter to a clip to discuss some of the differences between Resolve and other video apps supported by FxFactory. While features are largely equivalent to other video apps, Resolve doesn't yet support the same custom UI. Here is the same plugin in Final Cut Pro for comparison. I can switch halftoning technique in a single click. Whereas in Resolve, I can make the same adjustment through a pop-up menu. Range parameters, such as those to specify ink levels, are available in Resolve through a pair of sliders. And while other parameters do not sport the same appearance, features are usually accessible through a pop-up menu, such as presets. Or the object tracker, which gives me a great excuse to mention that Resolve supports the same set of custom on-screen controls you've seen in Final Cut Pro. Make sure your playhead sits within the selected clip and activate the OpenFX overlay. This gives me access to content-sensitive parameters on screen, such as presets or mask preview. And naturally, it lets me select a region of the frame to be tracked. And just like in other apps, I can fine-tune the results of the track simply by moving to a frame and repositioning the region as needed, tracking forward or backward again as needed. Next, I'll switch to the Photo Montage Generator, another plugin that makes excellent use of on-screen controls. I can click the Images button to select a few files from my slideshow and quickly apply a built-in preset. Resolve has excellent performance during previews and renders, but I'd like to draw your attention to an important technique to be avoided when using generators in Resolve. Never ever resize a generator from the head. As of Resolve version 20, any section you add by resizing a generator from its head will be frozen in time. Plugins that are supposed to animate, like Photo Montage, will fail to animate. Instead, only change the generator's duration by resizing its tail. This problem currently affects all third-party generators, and for some, like our Caption Burner plugin, the problem can be hard to diagnose. Caption Burner relies on exact clip timing to render subtitles at the right moment. Resizing its clip from the head introduces an unwanted pause before your subtitles begin to render. If you find yourself resizing a clip by accident, quickly undo this operation. Or if it's too late to undo, drag a new instance of the generator to your timeline. Next, I'll drag our new Block Party transition to discuss a more advanced topic. While our on-screen UI has been updated to improve effect configuration in Resolve, I'd like to shift your attention back to the Parameter Inspector to show a parameter that only exists when using our plugins in Resolve, Timeline Color Space. Because Resolve doesn't yet allow plugins to perform automatic color management, you have to make sure each plugin knows what color space the timeline is using. Resolve allows you to configure timeline color space both through project settings or through a timeline-specific option that overrides its equivalent project setting. This is done by toggling off this option and choosing a new color space just for this timeline. However you specify the timeline color space, make sure to match that selection through the parameter inspector to ensure accurate color reproduction. I'd like to end this introduction to FxFactory plugins in Resolve by mentioning the best part. Support for the new host is free, and most of our native plugins will be ready to use in Resolve by the time you're watching this video. Head over to our website, install FxFactory 9, and let us know what you think. Create with a wide range of great video effects at FxFactory.com.